three areas which I think are very important currently: psychiatry, oncology, and pain medication. I think we have a big contribution in psychiatry. For psychiatry, it's very difficult to estimate whether the drug is working or not, and people suffer from side effects. And to make sure that they do not suffer in vain from these side effects, it's good to have pharmacogenetics up front. The second area, I would like to mention oncology. Oncology is, of course, very important as well, because most of the drugs there are given to a level as high as much as possible to ensure a proper therapy. Failure of therapy you don't want to have, but toxicity is usually also dose limiting. The third area, which is very much important, is pain. It's only ethical that we establish upfront whether you will benefit from a pain-killing therapy instead of using trial and error that we're currently using.
The main therapeutic areas, it's psychiatry, I would say, it's internal medicine, it's oncology. However, there is one area that I think is extremely important, and that's the area of polypharmacy. The older a person grows, the more likely is the chance to end up with a whole list of drugs. Our champion had 43 drugs, but everything beyond 4 to 5 drugs, there are so many drug interactions that come in the play then as well. Those based on the genetics of that specific person makes it very challenging to find the right mix of drugs that is right for that specific person. Polypharmacy is going to be the most difficult area in order to educate physicians in how to cope and how to adjust the dosing and the prescription based on the pharmacogenetic report so that we can guarantee a safe situation for the patient.
If you have this one patient in front of you suffering from these side effects, you order a pharmacogenetic test and you can indeed see that the side effects are indeed explained by the pharmacogenetic information. Those clinicians, they adopt pharmacogenetics much faster because they realize they have more patients that may suffer from the same problems. And then we see the transition from ordering the test when there are side effects to ordering the test prior for start of certain therapies.
Technology providers as Illumina had shown the way in many ways already. Beyond DNA-based technologies, there may be other omic technologies which would be useful.
That we are at the beginning of that era, which it will be possible for everyone to have the power, the empowerment to decide on their own health. And the doctors will gain a complete different role. They will be given orientation, but the responsibility on our own health is going to be our own.